If, like me, you're looking to dip your toe into LED grow light technology, then I can't think of a better place to start than these 4-foot LED 5500 Kelvin lamps for propagation and vegetative growth. Did you hear that? Did you hear that? I slowed down and took a breath. Look, here's the thing. They can be retrofitted directly into your existing high-output T5 fluorescent light so you can start benefiting from LED technology straight away without investing in a whole new fixture. Amazing! It took less than a minute to pop out the old T5 lamps from the Sunblaze 42 high-output fixture and replace them with two AgroLED iSunlight white 5500 Kelvin LED lamps. The obvious benefit right off the bat is decreased power consumption. The two 4-foot LED lamps consume a total of just 82 watts of power instead of 110 watts with T5s. That's 25% savings right there. Plus, they're mercury-free. This may go some way toward convincing you to relamp at more than twice the cost of regular T5s. The light is super bright. I measured 350 micromoles, 6 inches, directly under two of the 4-foot lamps. I'm not going to tell you what I measured with, compared with around 160 micromoles for an equivalent pair of T5s. I tested the light intensity with both my Sun System PAR meter and the new Apogee MQ500, which has been fine-tuned for more accurate readings with LED grow lights. What's more, you can actually position your plants 6 inches away from the LEDs and there are no radiant heat issues. Try doing that under a regular high-output T5. I can actually touch the LED lamps with my bare hands after they've been on for 12 hours. Incredible! I'm particularly excited to use these lamps in my propagation grow tent because the cooler running temperatures means I can power my extraction fans right down to the minimum, or even have them come on intermittently using a thermostatic fan speed controller such as the Mercury 3, Mercury 4, or Spartan series. I live in an arid climate, so my ambient relative humidity tends to be low, 30 or 40%. Meanwhile, I like to keep my propagation grow tent at a steady 75 degrees Fahrenheit or 25 degrees Celsius. For healthy transpiration, my vapor pressure deficit should be between 0.4 and 0.78 kilopascals. That equates to a relative humidity of between 64 and 76%. If the heat from my grow tent forces my extraction fans to run all the time, that is, just to keep the temperatures in check, it invariably leads to plummeting relative humidity levels inside my propagation tent. By switching to LEDs, I've eased the conflict between the need to extract hot air away from the tent and retaining that precious humidity for my young plants. The AgroLED iSunlight tubes also come in a bloom spectrum, combining a 450 nanometer blue, 660 nanometer red, and a full spectrum white diode. Both spectrums are available in 2-foot or 4-foot tubes. So, it looks like I've doubled my light, lowered my power consumption by 25%, and created a better propagation environment just by switching to these LED tubes. Most importantly, my plants never looked happier. Temperatures in my deep water cloner are a lot more stable, too. If you're worried that humidity might be too low in your propagation tent, you could also try humidity domes or misting your plants. Some growers mist the inner lining of their grow tents, too, or set their plants up on GrowSmart trays with water in the tray beneath. That way, more water vapor enters the air without your plants sitting in puddles of water. I hope this video finds you all happy and well. Sorry I've been a little bit quiet lately. I've been busy in the background, I promise. So lots of stuff to come soon. Thanks for watching. This is Everest OUT.